I mostly focus on home improvements and fixing things around the house here, but a lot of us have iPhones, and maybe you've wondered, what happens if I never install Apple's updates? Here we have my iPhone 6S. I got this phone in early 2016 after the screen got damaged on my old 4S. Every time I updated the iOS on my 4S, it got slower. So I wanted to see what would happen if I never updated the iOS 9 operating system on my 6S. Everything was fine for a few years. Then things stopped working one by one. Here's a rundown of all the problems being on iOS 9 in 2020. The first issue is the news doesn't work. It just opens a blank screen. And it's done this for at least a couple of years now. You can see the phone is frozen. Not even the home button works. Facebook still works, for the most part. This is my own fault because I refuse to install Messenger and give Facebook the data of all my contacts. But one thing I'm missing out on is there's no Facebook Marketplace on here. There's no Facebook Watch either. So I don't waste too much time on Facebook. Let's look at YouTube. It works just fine. But this version is so old that I can't even do a live stream video. I need to have a newer iOS before I can update the app. Let's check the weather. Seems like it works all right. But the radar map doesn't work anymore. It never shows any precipitation anywhere. So I need a newer iOS to update that app. I used to be able to connect our bot back through my phone. Not anymore. eBay. No longer works. This error comes up every time and I can't update the app. Hey, at least I still have Flappy Bird, right? But I can get by without all those things. The latest thing that stopped working is email links. And that's kind of important. So when I'm reading an email and there's a link, if I click on it, the whole mail app freezes up, even if I hit the home button. It's still frozen when I go back. Nothing works at all. Same for text messages. If I click on a link, nothing happens. At least it doesn't freeze up the app though. Google is useful, and it mostly works. I can still search and get results. And click on those results. But then, if there's a link on any of the web pages, it won't work. Even if I try and open it in Safari, no go. And now Google is frozen. So how about Safari then? Here, I'll show you how to get it on Facebook Messenger. Facebook Basic. It's Facebook minus some bells and whistles meant for really old phones. But it works in the browser, and I could check messages through here. And I could even access Marketplace through the web version, but that recently stopped working as well. So will the web version of Google work through Safari? Here, let me show you. Some links work, but then some links don't work at all. So if I go to the App Store, there are some apps that I can update, but this is it. None of the apps that I need to update are available on iOS 9. Some of these apps are so old. Check this out. Let's see what version of Facebook I'm running. Version 41. Now let's go to the App Store and see what the current version is. 259! I'm almost 220 versions behind. I will say though, it's nice having a version before they started putting ads everywhere. But in the end, I have a smartphone that isn't really all that smart anymore. The links not working was the last straw for me. So it's time to update the iOS. Unfortunately, I've waited so long now that I have to go straight from iOS 9 to 13. 10, 11, or 12 aren't offered anymore. I'd rather take it one step at a time to be sure things still worked okay, but Apple doesn't give me much of a choice here. And it's only letting me update through iTunes on a computer. So this should be fun. I really want to be able to click links again though. So I'll be updating from 9 to 13 in my next video. Stay tuned.